This is Professor Rogers. In this presentation, we examine the basics of making graphs for categorical descriptive statistics. I move quickly through this material. I am not providing comprehensive instructions about features in Word and Word graphic capabilities, which can be found elsewhere on the Internet. I am only focused on how to adapt that information to making graphs within an APA-style paper. Some software packages have graphics capabilities within them. The graphics package within SPSS is especially well known. However, these packages are quite complicated, and given the number of times that most individuals would make graphs, using Word for graphs of categorical descriptive statistics is a better use of most people's time. As an example, we will be using the frequency table of the number of states by region. We have to have this table in our possession to make our graph. Like tables, graphs and figures in APA style get their own page at the end of the document. This page can be separated from the rest of the paper, including preceding tables, using a section break. There are two different formats for the page. The APA manual itself puts the title and description of figures below the figure. The descriptive word, such as graph, figure, or chart, is in italics, and on the same line is a title in regular font. Only the first word and major words of the title are capitalized. Authors are permitted to provide an extended discussion of the figure in the space to follow. An alternative format, often acceptable to many editors, puts the title above the graph in a manner similar to a table. However, there is only one line, not three, as in a table. This line separates the title from the graph. Students in my classes are free to use either format. Setting up a graph is driven by menus in Word. Under the Insert tab in the top menu, select Chart in the ribbon, and we get the Insert Chart command box with pictures of templates for various figures. For our example, we will start in the column chart in the upper left-hand corner of the Insert Chart box. What opens is an Excel spreadsheet with a template for entering data. What we see is in the picture on the left of the screen. The blue box highlights where the data for the chart is located and can be expanded and contracted based on the size of the data we type in. We then enter that data for which we want the visual representation. For our example, I am going to make a graph of the percent distribution of states by region. The data from the SPSS output are entered manually into the spreadsheet. The results are seen in the picture on the right of the screen. Right-click on the spreadsheet to close it, and then look at the Word document. What we see is a chart already assembled for us. There is already a good chart here, but there are still some fine points to get it properly formatted for our APA-style document. Notice that chart tools are now added to our menu whenever we highlight our chart. First, we size the graph on the page. Sizing is done by pulling on the edges of the graph. At the top of our chart is a title placed on the chart by default. We already have a chart title in the Word document, so we highlight the edge of the title box to see the box, and then delete the title box. On the right, there is a legend. When we have only one variable, the legend adds nothing to the chart, so we highlight the legend box and delete it the same way we removed the title. Next, we add axis titles. The command can be found in the ribbon under Layout. Choose the Axis Titles command from the menu. There could be some confusion because there is also an Axis command, but we want Axis Titles. Here we add two titles, one for the vertical axis and one for the horizontal. For vertical axis, I prefer the rotated title. Here's the result after I add the Axis Titles. You see region labeling the horizontal axis and percent of states on the vertical one. You notice that there are small tick marks on the horizontal axis. Many people today ignore these tick marks, but technically they imply that the data are numeric. To be correct, we must remove them. Highlight the horizontal axis with your cursor and right-click on the bottom of the axis. You should get a menu that includes the Format Axis command on the bottom. You might not get this menu the first couple of times you try. There are two different menus that are brought up by right-clicking on the axis, so sometimes I find I have to try several times before I get the one I want. Here's the dialog box for the Format Axis command. In the middle of the box are the settings controlling tick marks. Set them all to none and the tick marks disappear completely. An optional change is the addition of data labels. I like this option because it adds more information to the chart. The Data Labels command can be found on the ribbon under the Layout tab. I personally prefer the Outside End option, which puts the data labels above the bars. If I put the data labels on the bar, they are often not legible if the document is printed out on a black and white printer. I make three final adjustments to get my finished graph. First, I remove the border from my chart. By right-clicking on the chart, I get a menu that includes the Format Chart Area command, and I remove the border by turning the border color off. The value 33 for South crossed a grid line. I right-clicked on the box with the data label for South, and under Format Data Labels, I filled the box with white, which blocked out the grid line near the number 33. Finally, I left the chart and moved up my title so it is closer to the chart. My final graph is shown here. Once a graph is made, I can easily change the graph simply by right-clicking on it and selecting Change Chart Type. Here I selected a pie chart. The one alteration I had to make from the original pie chart was to add a legend for region, because I could not tell which slice of the pie was associated with each region given the data label. One caution should be made about pie charts. On a computer, we see the slices in color, but on a black and white or even a gray-toned printer, some of the slices might be indistinguishable. By right-clicking on each slice of the pie, we can play with the fill of the data point slices by color and pattern to get a pie chart that should work on most non-color printers. Graphs add a way to visualize the data. We don't see many graphs in journals because they use a lot of space and sizing them is complicated. However, they provide us an alternative way to display data outside a table when the situation is appropriate.